Hello everyone. Today let us discuss the few more properties of LTI system. In the earlier videos we have seen three basic properties for convolution for LTI system, that is commutative property, associative property and distributive property. For all these three properties we have seen how they are defined in the form of equation and how they are proved. Now today we are going to discuss three more properties which are important. Based on this many problems will come. The first one is memoryless system. This is one property. Second one is causal system, causality, and the third one is stable system, stability. These three are the properties. Just like in module 1 we have seen few of the properties for a system and we have seen certain conditions to be met for those particular properties, so similarly here also for LTI system these three properties we will define based on certain condition is met. First one, for memoryless system, what is the condition for memoryless system? Earlier in the module 1 we have seen how we used to define the memory based on whether the signal is the system is dependent on the past values or not. But however, here for LTI system we are going to define this particular property based on certain condition for impulse response, that is h of n or h of t for discrete and continuous time. This impulse response value should be zero for the time not equal to zero. This is the condition for system to be memoryless. What do you mean by this condition? N or t not equal to zero means this point. Here, except this point, both n not equal to zero means it can be any negative time or it can have any positive time. So on both sides, amplitude of this h of impulse response, h of n or h of t should be 0. We should not have any signal here, but it can have a signal at 0. That is the condition. For example, I have a signal here which has some amplitude on the left side and on the right side. Whether it is a memoryless system? No, because for t not equal to 0, you are having the amplitude. So this condition is not getting satisfied. Your amplitude should be 0, but here amplitude is present. No doubt at zero, there is no condition, so it can have or it cannot have. But however, on the left and right hand side, you should not have any amplitude. But here it is contradictory, so this is not a memoryless system. So this is the condition for memoryless. Now let us go for causal system. What is the condition for causal system? In earlier, we used to define the causality based on the time. It should be dependent, the system should be dependent on either present or the past value, but not the future value. That was the condition there. Here the condition is with respect to the impulse response, h of n or h of t. What is the condition for n less than 0 or for t less than 0, for time less than 0, that is on the left hand side, what all negative times are there, for that you should not have the any amplitude value for impulse response. That is, if a signal is present only at the right hand side, then the signal, the system is said to be causal. This is one example for causal system. If you observe here, you are having the amplitude at the right hand side, but here you don't have any amplitude on the left hand side, that is less than 0. The impulse response is 0. Yes, it is, the condition is getting satisfied for this particular diagram. So this is a causal system. Similarly, for continuous time, you have a signal at the right hand side. So for t less than 0, for the left hand side, you don't have any amplitude. So these are the examples for causal system. Now let us move to the stable system. Earlier, we used to define the stability based on the bounded input, bounded output. For a bounded input signal, the system should produce the bounded output, limited value. So here the condition is, if you evaluate, if you sum up the overall value of the impulse for a certain specific range for both discrete and continuous time, if you calculate this sum or the integral, this value should be less than infinity. Means this total calculation, what you do, this should be limited, should have some limited value which is less than infinity. If you get like this, then the system is said to be a stable system. So today we have discussed three properties: memoryless system, the condition is the impulse response value should be zero for time value not equal to zero, and for causality, the impulse response value should be zero for the time less than zero, that is left hand side value. Stability, if you calculate the sum of the impulse response values, if you calculate them, you should get one bounded value which is less than infinity. Then the system is said to be a stable system. This is about three more properties of convolution based on the impulse response for LTI system.